If we were to meet an extraterrestrial civilization, the chances of them being the same age as humanity are slim to none. If they're much younger than us, it might be difficult or impossible to communicate with them. But if they're older, say a billion years more advanced than us, then what might they be like? How would they look? What technology would they have? And what would they be capable of? Let's find out as we ask, what would a civilization 1 billion years older than us be like? Number 2. Technology. To imagine what a billion-year advanced civilization may look like, we must first consider where we humans are technologically and where we're likely to be in the future. To do this, we can use the Kardashev scale, a method of measuring a civilization's technological level based on the amount of energy it can harness. This scale was developed in the 1960s by Russian astrophysicist Nikolai Kardashev, and its first level describes a civilization that can harness 100% of the energy which reaches its home world from its parent star. As you might have guessed, we're not even close to achieving the bottom rung on that ladder yet. And after 4.5 billion years of faffing about with war, coal, and beanie babies, we're estimated to be at 0.73 on this scale. However, our progress of late has been pretty swift. It is thought we could reach Type 1 status within 100 years, although this does require humanity to put aside its differences and work together. So it's not exactly nailed on. But if we can, Kardashev believed it would take just another 3,200 years to reach Level 2 status, and this is where things really start to heat up. Type 1 civilizations can theoretically control volcanoes, the weather, and near-Earth objects, as well as being able to harness 100% of the sun's energy received on Earth. But a Type 2 civilization can harness 100% of the sun's energy, period. And they might do so using the theoretical Dyson sphere. Dyson spheres are theoretical large structures which can encompass a whole star. And we think we may have seen one being built in 2016. Remember the story about Tabby's star, whose dips in brightness could not be explained by science? That might have been an advanced civilization in the process of building a Dyson sphere. A Type 3 Kardashev civilization is able to colonize star after star using endless Dyson spheres to harness energy on a galactic scale. This could be done remotely by swarms of robots. And while Kardashev optimistically guessed we could do this within 5,800 years, others like Michio Kaku believe it'll be more like 100,000 to a million. A fourth Kardashev level has also been suggested, and this one we may not even notice if it were operating in our own backyard. Level 4 civilizations can theoretically control a universe. And this is how far advanced a race of beings a billion years older than us could be. While we're on terra firma fiddling with rocks, they're out there manipulating the stars themselves. And according to another technological scale, they may even be able to play with time, space, and transcend the multiverse too. The microdimensional mastery levels classify beings according to how small a scale they can work on. Type 1 can build structures and cut mines. Type 2 can manipulate genes, and further types up to level 6 can edit molecules, atoms, the atomic nucleus, quarks, and leptons. But the final level on this scale, Type Omega, would be capable of manipulating time and space itself. Humans have already mastered Type 3, and we've made strides towards achieving levels 4 to 6 as well. So, are we closer than we think to becoming a godlike civilization? Because if you could manipulate space and time, or even just stars and planets, your work would be on such a grand scale, it'd be indistinguishable from nature. Humanity itself could be the result of such work, as it's entirely possible some ancient civilization got lonely and slung a bunch of microbes towards Earth just for someone to talk to. These people could be our gods, or at least they'd appear to act like them, because just think how godlike modern humans would seem to the inhabitants of Earth 1 billion years ago, considering that during that time it was populated by single-cell organisms. You get my point. Number 1. Biologically. If you think it's hard to imagine what technology may exist in a billion years, it's even more difficult to comprehend what life may look like after such a million millennia of evolutionary development. On Earth, the first multicellular organisms only developed around 800 million years ago. So over 1 billion years, how would organic life develop? When you look at a single cell of bacteria and you compare its experiences, limitations, and capabilities to that of a human, how can we even comprehend what gifts another billion years of evolution may bring? Although that is assuming that evolution would continue biologically. If a race was 1 billion years older than us and had progressed along roughly the same technological direction, at some point, biological evolution may end. For if a civilization is capable of manipulating their own bodies on a cellular level, then that makes them practically immortal, invincible, and all-powerful. Where else do you go from there? You don't need gills, wings, or laser vision if you're able to edit yourself and the world around you. So, would a sufficiently advanced race shed its biological form and become entirely artificial in nature? Susan Schneider of the University of Pennsylvania thinks so, as she was quoted as saying, "I think it very likely, in fact, inevitable, that biological intelligence is only a transitory phenomenon. If we ever encounter extraterrestrial intelligence, I believe it is very likely to be post-biological in nature." Ever since we've dreamt of alien species, we've imagined strange creatures with tentacles, gray skin, and long, probing fingers. But it seems we've been thinking about them in entirely the wrong way. A billion-year advanced being may be technologically augmented to traverse and control the universe, because biological beings have limitations. A likely scenario is that an advanced civilization would use robots to travel across the universe, with self-replicating von Neumann probes heading out to colonize the cosmos while their biological masters stay home. It is even thought possible that an alien von Neumann probe could have kicked off life on Earth, with its remnants still left over on our planet or the moon. But a more important question concerns the nature of these robots. Are they a civilization's tool, or their successors? Will consciousness be able to be transported into a non-biological entity? And if so, is this how a billion-year advanced civilization would appear to us? It's certainly one possibility. But Arizona State's Paul Davies thinks we'd be lucky to even recognize a billion-year advanced civilization, because he believes they may not be made of matter at all. Imagine going back a few hundred years and trying to explain non-tangible concepts like software, music files, and porno JPEGs to a regular human. Then push that idea a billion years into the future and try to picture where technology may take us next. Paul Davies believes that advanced technologies and their masters may not have a physical form. They might not be constrained by size or shape, space or time. They won't act like we do. And they certainly won't think like we do. Alien civilizations a billion years ahead of us will operate on a level we cannot imagine, comprehend, or detect. And that means we wouldn't know if they were stood right in front of us. So this brings us to an interesting conclusion. One day, humans may develop the ability to understand and observe a billion-year advanced civilization. And on the day that we do, when we finally flip the switch to the non-physical entity detection machine, what happens next? Are we alone? Or are we surrounded? You can find out in our bonus video, how would we differ from an advanced civilization? which you can watch on our Patreon page at patreon.com/strangemysteries. This can be accessed by becoming a Patreon and signing up for a bonus video access at $2 per month, which also allows you to help us decide what videos to make, find out which topics are in the pipeline, and ask the Strange Mysteries team any questions you might have about our work, our lives, or our checkered sexual past. Patreon has become necessary since, amidst the chaos of advertisers ditching YouTube due to a few nasty videos, all other creators like us are having our arms twisted to make ad-friendly content. But we'd rather make videos about the things that interest you, and our ability to do this relies on you. For $2 a month, we can provide awesome bonus content for each video. And eventually, with your support, we can go fully ad-free and dedicate our full videos to just the juiciest ideas packed full of the most mind-blowing content we can find. If you can afford it, our Patreon page can be found at this link here in the upper right with the exclamation mark circle, description box, or you can visit patreon.com/strangemysteries and sign up there. Then you can find out what might happen if we met a super advanced civilization. If you cannot donate, then it's cool. We still love you. And we'll continue to provide the best content we can under YouTube's restrictions, as you'll see if you watch our recent video on what lies beyond the edge of the universe.